somebody, but open your mouth right now and begin to decree some things. Declare some things over your family, over your life. Come on, I'm going to give you about 30 seconds. Open your mouth and begin to speak some things and decree them over your life, over your family, over your ministry. Come on, open your mouth. Turn to your neighbor and say, I decree it. Amen. Out of the mouth of two or three witnesses, a thing is established. Hallelujah. You can't be timid right now. Hallelujah. You got to speak it. Amen. You got to declare it through the word of God. Because the word of God is true and everlasting. Hallelujah. I'm not going to leave you alone, because you got to get out of your seat right now. And you better go to three people. And you better begin to decree and declare some things that God has been speaking in your life right now. Come on, get out of your seat. Get out of your comfort zone. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. I know I'm going to push you. I'm going to push you. Hallelujah. Speak it out of your mouth. Declare it. Yeah. We speak it. We speak it, Lord. We speak it. We decree it, God. Come on, believe your word of God. He wants to give you a breakthrough right now. Hallelujah. Yeah, we speak healing. We decree a breakthrough of this city. We change the atmosphere by the power of the word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Speak it. Come on. Come on, I speak it. Speak it. Come on. Hallelujah. We're right here. We almost there. You got to get that breakthrough. Hallelujah. For the word of God declares it. I'm going to speak it. Glory, glory. Yeah. Begin to declare it. You got to open your mouth. Hallelujah. Yeah. Declare it, God, in this place. Name of Jesus. Yeah. Glory. Breakthrough. Breakthrough. Walls is coming down. We decree it. That religious spirit's got to go. We break it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah, it's mine, it's mine, it's mine. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Do you know tonight that all that Jesus did, he didn't do it because he was God. He did it because he loved you and I. Hallelujah. He didn't need saving. He did it to redeem us from our sins and set us free for his glory. Hallelujah. And that's the good news, that whomsoever will, let him come. Hallelujah. That's all you need to know. It doesn't matter where you've been. It doesn't matter what you look like. It doesn't matter what they said about you. It doesn't matter how bad the devil said you wasn't no good. I come out to tell you good news. He said, come just as you are, and I'll no wise cast you away for the glory and the power of God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. The Bible says there's life and death in your words. If you speak death, that's what's going to come about. Why? Because you are a speaking spirit. That's who you are. That's what God created you to be. How many of you know God is a speaking spirit? Everything God did, he spoke it. Let there be. Amen. And everything had to align itself with the power of the spoken word. Why? Because he's a speaking spirit. How many of you understand that you need to lay your hands on yourself and say, I've been created in his likeness. You are a speaking spirit. The enemy don't have to stop you. The enemy don't have to take your money. The enemy don't have to do that. As long as he can keep your mouth shut, amen, you will never walk into the breakthrough that God has for your life. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. I can have what I decree. Shift the atmosphere by the power of the word. Hallelujah. Not by emotions. You don't even move God because of your need. Don't get offended. God's not moving after your need. Hallelujah. God says, I'm waiting for somebody that will begin to declare who I am and call after me. See, there's power, there's salvation in the name of Jesus. The Bible says this, those that will call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. The name of Jesus is not just for healing. The name of Jesus is also for salvation. Because you know what the word Jesus, the name Jesus means? It means Savior. Or he that is able to save. So he gives us a profound scripture that says, those that will call upon the name of the Lord. There's so much power in that name that, amen, they can be saved. Salvation comes by the power of the name. Now, that might not fit in mine in your theology, but that's how the word of God works. That's the power of the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because, you know, we was raised, you got to go step this step, that step, and get right. And he says, if you'll call on my name, you can be saved. Because it is the power of the name. I want to just read this scripture for you tonight. Amen. And then we're going to open the altar up. Listen, I want you to know today, tonight, that the Spirit of the Lord is here to heal and deliver and set the captives free. Hallelujah. I'm not going to preach. I'm going to just give you some instructions for the night service. Amen. I'm going to be preaching later on this week. Amen. In another place. But I didn't come. This is not what this is about. I just want to instruct you for what we believe the Holy Spirit wants to direct you right now as we enter in and open the altar for prayer and for believing for healing and restoration. This is not just for you. May be sitting here and say, well, I'm already saved. Amen. But there's some stuff in your life. You're here tonight, and the Holy Spirit says that I need to clean your closet. Amen. But here's what the Holy Spirit spoke to me to read to you tonight. Matthew chapter 12, verses 9 through 14. Very profound story. It says, and when he went on from there and entered their synagogue, a man was there with a withered hand. And they asked him, is it lawful to heal on the Sabbath so that they might accuse him? They had no compassion or concern about the man's condition. Because you notice he was already in church. Hallelujah. They were concerned about if Jesus was going to break the Mosaic law, religion. Oh, don't get mad at me. I'm just going, just talking to us. See, religion tells you got to act a certain way. But if you'll open your heart and light the Holy Spirit, he'll mess you up tonight. He'll get you out of your box tonight. Hallelujah. Amen. It's been a long time since some of us ever got drunk. I'm from old school. I remember the days when we get drunk in the Holy Ghost and they'd have to drive you home. Hallelujah. Amen. Some of y'all don't act like y'all don't know nothing about that. Amen. You ought to read Acts. Amen. Watch this. So that they might accuse him, he said unto them, which one of you who has a sheep, if it falls into a pit on the Sabbath, will not take hold of it and lift it out? Of how much more valuable is a man than a sheep? Hallelujah. Can I challenge you tonight? Where do you have your priorities? Hallelujah. Where you are put, what are you putting value on in your life? Praise the Lord. I'm not preaching. I want to share this with you. So is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath? Then he said unto the man, you know, the man that was in church with a withered hand, your hand. Hallelujah. Now you got to understand the picture. We got a bunch of pastors and leaders here from different churches, and we thank God for all of you. You got to understand this picture here now, that this man's hand was completely withered without any motion at all. It had been decaying over the process of time. Hallelujah. Jesus did not speak to his hand. He spoke to his obedience. For in your obedience will unlock the manifestation of his glory in your life. Stripes we are healed. Hallelujah. There's nothing God cannot do. Is there anything too hard for the Lord? What God is saying, I need to stretch my people to walk in obedience for this season that God is about to unfold in 2023. Are y'all with me? And here's what happens. The man stretched out, and as he stretched out his hand, the impossible, through the act of obedience that was impossible, becomes reality. That's a word for somebody right here. You're facing a dilemma in your life that's beyond your control, that's impossibilities. The doctor said this. That one said that. That one said that you always got to have that sugar. Y'all always going to have to take that insulin. But I come by to tell you tonight, God said, stretch. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You can put yourself in this man's position. Come on, Jesus. What do you mean? You got to heal me first. Then I can stretch. He says, no, I need you to act upon faith, to activate faith in obedience. And then I'll begin to show forth the glory of God. That's what this meeting's about. That's what this weekend's about. There's some folks that God led you here from many miles. Hallelujah, to get here tonight. And God said, I'm about to demand out of you an act of obedience to stretch. And in your stretching, this is what takes place. It was restored. Hallelujah. Matter of fact, the Holy Spirit goes on to say it was restored healthy. He didn't just say it was made whole and it was healed. He said, I'm going to give you a comparison of how it was healed. What was the end result? It was back to its original place of purpose. See, some of you tonight, you think the enemy has tried to convince you, and some of you are convinced that what happened, you done and lost it, and it's over with, and it can never come again. But I come out to tell you that God's in the restoration business. Hallelujah. There's some of you walked away from your ministry. You've been walked away from church. You walked away from God. You walked away from God's calling on your life because somebody hurt you, somebody talked about you. But God says, I'm ready to stretch you tonight that I can make you whole. Amen. And what I'm about to do, amen, will compare back to the divine purpose of God. You may think you waste time's been too far gone and you've wasted too much time. I can't get it back. But in a moment, in an instant, God's going to restore back to the moment. Is anybody hearing what I'm saying to you tonight? Healthy, restored whole, just like the other. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's about to do it in your life. Praise the name of the Lord. But the restraints that's been holding you, you're blaming it on people. And it ain't the neighbor, it ain't the preacher, it ain't this one, it ain't that one. It's your lack of obedience to stretch. You imagine how many times he went to that dead Pharisee church and sit up there with a withered hand, and nothing happened. See, God is about to bring restoration back into the kingdom for people's lives to be restored. And I prophesy to you tonight, I'm fixing to open an altar tonight. You want to come, we want to pray with you. We have other prayer partners, pastors are here. Amen. And I want to tell you, there's not many people, there's, matter of fact, I don't believe there's anybody in this building tonight that don't need to come, because God brought you here for a divine purpose. And what you thought was lost, God says, if you'll step out of your comfort zone, amen, hallelujah, if you'll step out of your comfort zone and let him demand obedience and walk in that obedience, say, God, I believe you. I don't know how it's going to happen. I don't know how you're going to fix this, because it's beyond repair. It's beyond, I tried to fix it. I tried to get my child off crack, but I can't do it. I don't know what else to do, but I come out to tell you tonight that he's a restorer. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. But he's waiting for you to believe and walk in obedience. Say, I'm reeling, Lord. I hear you calling me. The praise team's going to come and sing tonight. You can stand to your feet. Listen, I want you to engage tonight. Listen, that's the reason why this is not a regular revival kind of setting of preaching, preachers getting up preaching and that kind of thing. Because God told me to set these kind of meetings, and this is the first of four this year. Matter of fact, in March we'll be at, and May we'll be at, Brother Dr. Collins is in Fayetteville doing this same thing over again in a different arena. But I want you to know the reason why God said did this is because there are people hurting, and I'm calling them to myself. Hallelujah. The remnant is being summoned. That's what this gathering is about. There's some ain't going to move. God can't move them. They ain't going to do nothing. They're going to sit on their seat or do nothing and complain about everybody else. I mean, I ain't going to try to speak negative. That's okay. They can do whatever they want to do. But I'm not going to sit back and stay in my smallness. Amen. Because I got a great God. And if you got a great God, he deserves a great praise. You can't give him a patty cake praise. If you're going to give him a praise, you're going to have to pour it out of your soul, out of your spirit, and open your mouth and declare. They're about to sing tonight. We're opening this altar. We're here. We want to pray for you. I believe for your healing. Listen, there is no sickness that God is not willing and desiring and able to heal tonight. Hallelujah. I'm going to tell you this little story. Just the other night, me and my wife was getting ready, and we were talking about some scripture and stuff. And she went into the kitchen. And when she went into the kitchen, her nose started pouring blood. She don't never have a nosebleed. And we, you know what we were studying? The power of the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And it began to pour. And she hollered at me, and she came running in there. She said, look, my nose is just pouring blood. The napkin was full of blood. And she went in the kitchen to get another, and I said, claim it on the name of Jesus. And I heard her in the kitchen. She said, I'm healed. You stop bleeding in the name of Jesus. She's here tonight, and I declare to you, not another drop came from her nose. Hallelujah. Matter of fact, there she is right there. Hallelujah. Amen. I want you to know tonight, that's the God that we serve. He is not, it's not gone out. The power and the manifestation of God's glory and healing and deliverance, they ain't gone nowhere. We've got in our box, and we won't get out of our comfort zone to believe God for the supernatural. Mama, you got something you want to say? Amen.
I can't let the night pass without standing up and saying what I need to say. Because when you start talking about the name of Jesus, that hits me. Because, you know, sometimes we just have to be reminded. And one reason I want to come up tonight, I don't want to let this night pass and you've came and you've sat and you've left. I want us to grasp this opportunity to get in His presence. And once you get in His presence and you touch the hem of His garment, you will not leave the way you came. And that's my heart tonight. I didn't come just because I needed something to do. As a matter of fact, I was so beat up and worn getting here, I said, if I can just walk through the front door, it'll be a victory for me. But God. And then when He starts talking about the name of Jesus, I'm like, let me tell you, I can tell the crowd something about the name of Jesus, about speaking the name of Jesus. Let me tell you something. Just that one word, if you say that word with faith, did you know that that's a prayer all within itself? And that one simple prayer unleashes the power in heaven, the power of our Heavenly Father, and it comes right away. It's right there, in that moment, in that need, right there. If you can just whisper the name of Jesus. I remember it so vividly as a child, and I guess the Lord lets you go through things that you're going to remember and use it and carry it with you. But I remember my mama walking into my bedroom, and we've had a fever, and the sheets are wet because of the fever. And I remember her laying her hand on me and saying, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I remember seeing her look out a window at a storm that was passing by, and the trees were bending over, and it was a tornado. We didn't know it at that time. But I remember I could see my mama having her hands out, saying, in the name of Jesus, peace be still. I saw those things, and that sparked a belief in that little girl that if I get in trouble and I need something, all I gotta do is call on the name of Jesus. If I can just say that name, if I can just say that name. And so tonight, that's what I want. I don't even know if I'll be able to sing, but if I can't, y'all sing it. I just need it to be released in the atmosphere. We're going to call on the name of Jesus. This sort of takes you back to, it's sort of old school, but honey, calling on Jesus will never get out of date in my book. You can give me all the new stuff I like. I like glitter and this and that. But honey, when it comes down to it, let me call on Jesus. Let me call on Jesus, because if I can get to where He's at, He'll meet my need. He'll make me speak the name of Jesus against everything that the destroyer came. He came to steal, kill, and destroy. And that covers all the bases. It might be drugs. It might be alcohol. It might be cancer. It might be depression, oppression. It covers all of it. Let me tell you that. The name of Jesus covers all of that. Just like His blood will wash away all those sins. His blood. So tonight, I don't even know if I can sing it, Sylvia. You may have to come and get it going. That's... We're calling on You tonight, Lord. We're calling on You, Jesus. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. How I love. I love just calling Your name. Whoa. Oh, Jesus. Oh, every day, Your name is the same. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, how I love. I love just calling Your name. When trouble surrounds me, I don't have to despair. Because, Lord, you told me that you'd always be there. Seems like all my problems had just begun to do what's called. Sometimes in the morning, sometimes late at night. But when I get up off my knees, everything.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
just got to obey the Lord. The Spirit of the Lord told me to just encourage someone tonight. There's someone here tonight, you've been dealing with a sickness. It's been affecting your shoulder, your right shoulder, your back area. Amen. The Holy Spirit told me to encourage you to come. We want to anoint you in the name of Jesus for you to be.
Fighting, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon. My soul needs a friend. So I'll run to the Father again and again and again.
Listen, I'm obeying the Lord now. Hallelujah. Listen, if you want God to touch you, you need to move right now. While the Spirit of the Lord is here. Hallelujah. I want you to grab hands. Praise the name of the Lord. My brother, listen to me. I want you to look at me. What the Spirit of the Lord says. There's things that has been in your past that the enemy is trying to keep bringing up to you. Am I on track? Hallelujah. And the enemy is trying to convince you that you're undeserving and what God has for you. See, you married into a gifted woman of God. Hallelujah. And you know that. Amen. Amen. But see, you to hate you her covering. You're a husband. And you're a team. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. And see what God is about to birth in you. Hallelujah. It's going to blow your mind. That's what we're doing right now. These men of God is stirring the gift, the anointing. Yeah. Glory to God. I break it off of his life.
Oh, 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 oh.
This past is covered by the blood of Jesus.
Oh, oh, oh.
Sister, I want you to hear this. The Lord gave me something. He said, I didn't know if you had any children. And I looked over here and said, she's pregnant. Didn't I ask you that? Here's what I hear the Lord say. The seed is not just a normal seed. There's a supernatural seed that God has sent to the earth because he's got an enemy he's going to take down. He said that this seed shall possess the gates of the enemy. This seed that inside of you, honey, you carry like Mary carried. You've got it almost. You carry life. You carry like Hannah carried. In the name of Jesus, thank you for the supernatural seed of possessing the gates of the enemy. I want you to say this, that seed shall possess the gates of the enemy.
Come on, church. Come on. Let's lift the praise with it. Hallelujah. God is. How many of you believe in God's divine healing?
Hallelujah. Yeah.
This lady has lupus, and she's having a problem speaking in her voice. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Sister, I want you to raise your hands. I want you to lift your hand this way. I want you to believe with us. Come on. Hallelujah. We need some prayer partners. Come on, Pastor. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We say to that tongue, be loosed. Hallelujah. We cast it out in the name of Jesus. We break it off of your life. Lupus, there's no name. Lupus, you have a name. There's no name above the name of Jesus. You must bow. You must give heed. I bind it. I cast it out of this woman. In the name of Jesus, the power of the Holy Ghost. Be free. Be healed. Open your mouth. Open your mouth and begin to declare. Open your mouth and begin to declare. Hallelujah. In Jesus. In Jesus. Powerful name. Glory to God. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Sister, listen to me. I just hear the Spirit of the Lord. I have an unction to pray. There's some generational curses that's been regenerating over your life for years. I got to break that off. Listen, I'm not rebuking you. I'm rebuking that demon, that spirit that's been attached to your family. God told me to break it off of your family right now in the name of Jesus. This is a good friend of mine. I'll grab hands. Grab her hand, brother. Hallelujah. I hope you don't mind. I just feel led. Hallelujah. They just planted a church here in the Rockingham area called City Light Church. Hallelujah. And they need the blessing of the gatekeepers. Some of you, this pastor's been here for many, many years. Some of you have forgot what it takes from building something from the ground up. Hallelujah. But some of you hadn't forgot. You know what it takes. They need some encouragement tonight. Hallelujah. They need you to pray over them. Hallelujah. And welcome in them to this city. Hallelujah. For the glory of God. I'm not from Rockingham. I'm from Wagram. I'm wherever I lay my hat at. Amen. But this is a great couple with a great anointing on their life. And I want to call for you pastors, every one of you. Pastor Eddie, all you guys come. And wives, amen, I want you to come. I want you to surround this couple, and I want you to pray over them tonight. I want you to bless them. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Be encouraged, sister. Glory to God. Fresh fire. Spirit of worship, rise up. Praise the name of the Lord. You are loved in this city. You are welcomed in this city. You come right now, I want to pray for you. Whoever you are, there's some hard things going on. Hallelujah. I want you to, will you walk in obedience right now? Will you step out in obedience and come? I hear the Spirit of the Lord say, amen. You've been having some heart issues, some things going on with your heart. Hallelujah. I want to pray for you right now in the name of Jesus. That's you. Take a step. Take a step right now.